Now we can find the charges after connection. Q1 dash equal to C1V. C1 into V is nothing but Q1 plus Q2 by C1 plus C2. So C1 by C1 plus C2 into Q. Now Q equal to Q1 plus, where Q equal to Q1 plus Q2, that is the total charge on the system. And Q2 dash equal to C2V, so C2 into Q1 plus Q2 by C1 plus C2, then C2 by C1 plus C2. Since Q1 plus Q2 equal to Q, so C2 by C1, C1 plus C2 into Q, where Q is total charge on the system. Now we can find the ratio between these two, Q1 dash and Q2 dash, that is the ratio of charge after redistribution. So Q1 dash by Q2 dash equal to C1V by C2V. So Q1 dash by Q2 dash is nothing but C1 by C2, because we cancel each other. So and also equal to ratio between those respective radiuses also, in case of spherical conducts. In case of spherical conductors only. When charge flows through the conducting wire, then the energy is lost mainly on account of Joule effect. Electric energy is converted into heat energy. So change in energy del U equal to UF minus US, that is final energy minus initial energy. Then 1 by 2 C1 V square minus plus 1 by 2 C2 V square. This is final energy because they have common potential. So 1 by 2 C V square is the general formula. So since common potential, 1 by 2 C1 V square plus 1 by 2 C2 V square minus 1 by 2 C1 V1 square plus 1 by 2 C2 V1 square, that is C2 V2 square, that is before connection. So del U equal to 1 by 2, that is minus 1 by 2. If you simplify the above equation, you get minus 1 by 2 C1 C2 by C1 plus C2 V1 minus V2 the whole square. Here the naive design indicates the energy of the system decreases in the process.